From the local tree, we select a couple of devices connected via USB and bring them on our global view. To connect Ethernet devices, we first select the models from the virtual tree, an Xbox MD and a Monton 42, and then, with a click on the globe icon, we added the IP addresses, starting with the Xbox MD. We pull the info from the devices, which goes online. We repeat the operation for the Monton 42, we close the window, so we are ready to double-click on the device, which is now online. Let's save this project. From the File menu, we select Save. The default name of a new project is Untitled, with the .globcon extension. Let's type a name for the project, Test Globcon for example, and then click on Save. If we now open the project previously saved, the system will clean up the entire global view and prompt a window with the complete list of the devices stored in the project, with their actual status and the synchronization choice. By default, we are offered to pull the settings from all the devices, but we can decide individually between push, pull, or offline, clicking on the relevant radio button, or take a general decision clicking on the global buttons on the right. Pull will copy the actual status of the devices into the software project. Push will copy the software settings into the device. After pull or push, the device will go online. The offline choice will simply open the device in the global view without synchronizing the settings with the relevant device. Once decided our opening strategy, we can click on the Proceed button. In this example, we have decided to pull all, and therefore we have refreshed the project with the actual settings from all the devices. Let's now add a virtual device, for example an M1K2. The white Ethernet icon indicates the virtual status. Click and hold on that icon to pop up a comprehensive agenda. Let's now save the current project. The system will update the existing Test Globcon project. If we want to create a new file, just select Save As from the File menu. Opening the project, we expect to see a longer list of devices, including the virtual M1K2, obviously with no sync option. Once again, we are requested to decide the sync method for each device. This time, we decide to start offline with all the devices and click on Proceed. The entire project is loaded and showed in the global view with all the local and network devices in offline mode, plus one virtual device. We can operate on devices even if they are in offline mode. New settings are stored in the software and not immediately transferred to the real device. Let's change a patch on the Andiamo MC ID1, for example. Routing MADI input number 1 and 2 in pairs to the first 16 analog outputs. Once ready with all the desired settings changed, we can push the software situation to the real devices. Right-click on the device in the global view and select the push command. A confirmation is needed to proceed. Thanks to the push command, the device gets updated with the latest software settings. It's quite clear the output patch of the Andiamo MC has changed according to our desire. After the push command, the device goes in online mode and stays connected in real time with the software. We can perform a pull on the Andiamo 2, the same for the Xbox MD, and for the Monton 42. The M1K2 stays in virtual mode until a link with the real device will be established, entering a valid IP address. At Globcon startup, local ports are scanned looking for connected devices. That operation takes a while. If we immediately open a project, we may be asked to wait until the local devices are detected and properly managed. Once completed, the Proceed button is activated. Decided the sync strategy for all the devices, we can click on Proceed and start the globcon session. Powerful, easy, globcon.